Hello friends, in this video we are going to study reciprocating air compressor. But before moving to reciprocating air compressor, let us get to know why air is used in the industry. It is used in refrigeration, in air conditioning, for various cleaning purposes, in blast furnace, in power plants and many other applications. So, this compressed air is produced from reciprocating air compressor. Basically, let us know what is a compressor. So, air compressor is that machine which takes in atmospheric air, compresses it with some mechanical energy and then lets out the air which is at higher pressure. We can classify this compressor in various parts like positive displacement and dynamic compressor. Again, positive displacement is classified in two parts. Reciprocating air compressor and rotary air compressor. Reciprocating even again in single stage, multi stage, single acting, double acting. And rotary in centrifugal compressors, axial, vane blowers, root blowers and many more compressors. But today our topic is reciprocating air compressor. Now let us see construction and working of a reciprocating compressor. So in this diagram you can see reciprocating air compressor is basically of piston and cylinder arrangement. So we are having piston, piston rings, connecting rod, crankshaft, camshaft, cylinders, inlet valve and outlet valve. And these are the water jackets. So water jackets are provided for cooling purpose. So how does this compressor works? As piston starts moving from top dead center to bottom dead center, whatever leftover air in the cylinder starts expanding. So as this piston reaches bottom dead center, there's a vacuum created in the cylinder and the atmospheric pressure automatically flows inside the cylinder due to the property of air which moves from higher pressure to lower pressure. And after piston starts moving towards top dead center, the air present in the cylinder compresses and it is let out through the delivery valve. Now you can see in this PV diagram, process C2-1 is suction process. Process 1-2 is polytropic compression which follows the law PV raised to N is equal to constant. And process 2-D is delivery. We can see few formulas, important one to find out indicated work input to the compressors. Till now we had seen single acting reciprocating air compressor. Let us take a glance on double acting compressor. The arrangement was same as that of single acting, but just there's additional inlet valve and delivery valve at the opposite part of the initial valve. As piston starts moving from top dead center to bottom dead center, there's suction taking place in the first portion and compression and delivery taking place in the other portion. When piston start moving from bottom dead center to top dead center, the process goes on vice versa. Hence, this is the working of double acting compressor. So the next point is types of compression process taking place in a compressor. Type 1 polytropic compression, type 2 isentropic compression and type 3 isothermal compression. So from this PV diagram, you can see three types of processes. One process 1-2 polytropic compression which follows the law PV raised to N is equal to constant. Process 1-2 double dash isentropic compression which follows the law PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. And process 1-2 dash isothermal compression which follows the law PV is equal to constant. The minimum amount of work required is in case of isothermal compression. So we can see the formulas over here. Polytropic compression, work input to the polytropic compression, work input for isentropic compression and work input for isothermal compression. The difference between polytropic compression and isentropic compression is the index used N in polytropic compression and gamma in isentropic compression. The value usually is 1.4. So guys, this diagram is really important one. So these are few formulae helpful while solving the problems. Friends, till now we have seen the concept by neglecting clearance volume. Now we'll see it with clearance volume. So in this PV diagram, you can see process 1-2 is compression, process 3-4 is expansion. Both the processes follow same law, PV raised to N is equal to constant. V3 is equal to clearance volume VC. Effective swept volume is V1 minus V4 and swept volume is V1 minus VC. So initially we had seen the formula of indicated work input. So just there's a slight change in the formula when we include the clearance. V1 is replaced by V1 minus V4. Next, moving on towards the next point, free air delivery. So the volume corresponding to atmospheric conditions is known as free air delivery and the formula is as below. Next, we move on to volumetric efficiency. It is the actual mass sucked divided by mass corresponding to swept volume, or in short we can say it is the ratio of effective swept volume to swept volume, V1 minus V4 divided by V1 minus VC. And it also can be simplified as 1 plus C minus C into P2 by P1 raised to 1 upon N, where C is clearance ratio VC upon VS, that is clearance volume divided by swept volume. Now let us solve few problems on this topic. So problem number 1. The following data refers to a performance test of a single acting single stage 120 mm by 90 mm reciprocating air compressor. Now usually bore by stroke is mentioned in such a way. So bore is 120 mm and stroke is 90 mm. Moving further, suction pressure and temperature is given 1 bar and 25 degrees Celsius. Discharge pressure and temperature is 5 bar and 180 degrees Celsius. Compressor RPM is 1000. Shaft power, which is also known as brake power or actual power, is equal to 3.5 kW. Mass of air delivered is equal to 1 kg per minute. Find volumetric efficiency, indicated power, isothermal efficiency and mechanical efficiency. As we have discussed the problem, now let us see what is given. So diameter D is 0.12 meters. Stroke L is 0.09 meters, pressure P1 and P2 is 1 bar and 5 bar, temperature T1 is 298 Kelvin and temperature T2 is 453 Kelvin. N is 1000 RPM, shaft power is 3.5 kilowatts and mass flow rate is 1 kg per minute, which is equal to 0.0167 kg per second. Let us find out the first term, volumetric efficiency. So the volume, theoretical volume flow rate is given by the formula pi by 4 d square L m divided by 60. So substituting all the values, we'll be getting the final answer as 0.017 and the units is meter cube per second. Now since we know the formula, PV is equal to mRT, where V dot 1 is volume flow rate and m dot 1 is mass flow rate corresponding to the swept volume. So hence we can find out the mass flow rate by the formula PV upon RT. So ultimately we get the answer 0.02 kg per second. Please remember all the units. These are very important ones. Now finally the volumetric efficiency, we have the formula. Substituting both the values and we get the answer as 83.33%. So when this question is asked for 10 marks, this PV diagram consists of 1 mark and volumetric efficiency consists of 3 marks. Now let us find next point, indicated power. So we have already seen the formula for indicated power is mCp delta T. So when m is in mass flow rate kg per second, the ultimate final answer for indicated power will be getting in kilowatts. So substituting all the values, we are getting 3.1155 kilowatts. Now next point is isothermal efficiency. So before finding the isothermal efficiency, we need to find indicated power for isothermal compression. So we have already seen in the formula list, the formula is mRT ln of P2 by P1. So substituting all the formulas, we are getting it as 2.753 kilowatts. Now moving on to isothermal efficiency. So already we have seen the formula. Substituting the values, we are getting it as 78.66%. And the final point is mechanical efficiency. So we have seen the formula of mechanical efficiency as indicated power upon brake power or shaft power. So substituting both the values, we are getting the answer as 89.01 kilowatts. So this problem can come for university for approximately 10 marks. We have already seen 1 mark was for PV diagram, other 3 marks for volumetric efficiency, 2 marks for indicated power, 2 marks for isothermal efficiency, and the leftover 2 marks for mechanical efficiency. This problem is important from university point of view. Now, moving on to next problem. A single stage, double acting, reciprocating air compressor works between 1 bar and 10 bar. The compression follows the law PV raised to 1.35 is equal to constant. The piston speed is 200 meter per minute and the compressor speed is 120 rpm. The compressor consumes an indicated power of 62.5 kW with volumetric efficiency of 90%. Calculate number 1 diameter and stroke of the cylinder and number 2 clearance volume as percentage of stroke volume. Now in this sum, let us see given. So given pressure, initial pressure 1 bar, final pressure 10 bar, N is 120 rpm. Volumetric efficiency is 90%, piston speed is 200 meter per minute, indicated power directly is given 62.5 kilowatts. It follows the law PV raised to N is equal to constant, hence N is equal to 1.35, and it is a double acting compressor. Now let us find the solution. Point number 1, bore and stroke length. So initially we have to find indicated work input to the cylinder. So we know the formula, it is IP into 60 divided by 2N. So ultimately we'll be getting the answer of indicated work input as 15.265 kilojoule per cycle because indicated power was in kilowatt. Further, we know the formula for indicated work input as follows. We have already found out the value of work input over here. So substituting this value in this formula, directly we are getting the value of V1 minus V4, which is equal to 0.0496 m³. Now hence we moving forward, we know the formula for volumetric efficiency, which is equal to effective swept volume divided by swept volume. So we have to find out the value of swept volume. We know the value of volumetric efficiency and the term V1 minus V4. So substituting both these terms over here, we are getting swept volume is equal to 0.0551 m³. So if this problem is asked approximately for 10 marks in the university question, this work input, it carries 2 marks and swept volume consists of 2 marks. Now we know formula for piston speed is equal to 2ln. In case of double acting, it is 2ln, and in case of single acting, it is only ln. So further simplifying and substituting the value of V piston is equal to 120, we get L is equal to 0.83 meters. So stroke length is equal to 833 mm. Also, we know swept volume formula is pi by 4 d square L. So further simplifying and substituting the values, we get the answer as 0.29 meters, which is equal to 290 mm. So we get both the values, L is equal to 833 mm and D is equal to 290 mm. And the next point is to find clearance ratio, which is mentioned by C. C is equal to VC upon VS, which we have already seen in the formula. So the formula for volumetric efficiency is equal to 1 plus C minus C into P2 by P1 raised to 1 upon N. So substituting the value of volumetric efficiency and pressure P2 P1, ultimately we get the answer C is equal to 0.222. So usually we mention this C in the form of percentage, and the mass distribution is 2 marks were for indicated power, 2 marks were for swept volume, 2 marks for stroke length, 2 marks for diameter, and the remaining 2 marks for clearance ratio. Now let us see last problem on this topic. A twin cylinder, single stage, single acting, reciprocating air compressor running at 300 rpm has pressure ratio of 8. The clearance is 3% of the swept volume. It compresses 30 m³ per minute free air at 101.3 kilopascal and 20 degrees Celsius. According to the law, P V raised to 1.3 is equal to constant. The temperature rise during suction stroke is 25 degrees Celsius. The loss of pressure through intake and discharge valve is 8 and 150 kilopascals respectively. Determine number 1, indicated power required by the compressor. Number 2, brake power assuming compression efficiency of 85% and mechanical efficiency of 95%. And number 3, cylinder dimensions for same bore and stroke size. Now remember, this is not a multi-stage problem. It is single stage, single acting. Just it is a twin cylinder. Means number of cylinder used over here are 2. As we have seen in the question, the given is number of cylinders are 2. Remember, it is not a multi-stage compressor. It is a single stage compressor with just number of cylinders 2. Clearance is 3% of the swept volume. Number of rotations are 300 rpm. The index N is 1.3. Free air delivery is 300 meter cube per minute. Pressure at free air condition is 101.3 kilopascal and temperature at free condition is 20 degrees Celsius. It is also given that stroke length is equal to diameter of bore. Then the pressure difference at inlet is 8 kilopascal and at delivery it is 150 kilopascal. The pressure ratio is given as 8. Compressor efficiency 85% and mechanical efficiency 95%. The inlet temperature is given as 45 degrees Celsius. Now let us see how to solve this problem. Initially we have to find out suction pressure with help of this formula. So we get pressure P1 is equal to 93.3 kilopascals. Now from the relation for ideal gas, we know the relation is equal to PV is equal to MRT. When M and R are constant, we get PF VF upon TF, means at free air delivery conditions, we obtain PV upon T1 at initial conditions. So later on, simplifying this formula, we get the value of V1 minus V4 and substituting all the values, we get direct answer as 35.5 meter cube per minute for the value of V1 minus V4. Moving ahead, let us find the point indicated power input. So initially with neglecting clearance, we had the formula IPA is equal to N upon N minus 1, P1 V1, P2 by P1 raised to N minus 1 upon N minus 1. But now when we include clearance, V1 is substituted by V1 minus V4, which we have already found out the value as 35.5 meter cube per minute. So to find the answer in kilowatts, we need this in meter cube per second. Hence we divide 35.5 by 60. So I'm substituting the rest values, we get IP is equal to 146.7 kilowatts. Next term is brake power. We know the efficiency formula. Efficient mechanical efficiency is equal to indicated power upon brake power. So hence we get brake power is equal to indicated power upon mechanical efficiency. In this problem, compressor efficiency is also given. Even if other efficiencies are given, we have to divide all those efficiencies over here. Hence we'll get total efficiency. So substituting all the values, we get brake power is equal to 181.67 kilowatts. Next term is cylinder dimensions. Cylinder dimensions means diameter and length of stroke of cylinder. So to find that, we need to find the formula of swept volume. And to find swept volume, we need to find volumetric efficiency. So we know the formula for volumetric efficiency is equal to 1 plus C minus C into P2 by P1 raised to 1 upon N. Substituting all the values, we get volumetric efficiency is equal to 0.8814. We also know the formula for volumetric efficiency is equal to effective swept volume upon total swept volume. Effective swept volume is V1 minus V4 and total swept volume is Vs. Hence, we get Vs is equal to V1 minus V4 upon volumetric efficiency. So, substituting, we get 40.1 meter cube per minute. That is the total swept volume. Also, now that we have two cylinders for single stage, we have the formula of swept volume as 2 into pi/4 d²ln. But as in the question we have seen, it is given diameter is equal to stroke of cylinder. We find out the value of diameter, which is equal to length of stroke, is equal to 0.44 meters, which is equal to 440 mm. So in university, it is approximately asked for 10 to 12 marks. The distribution is like V1 minus V4 was for 2 marks, indicated power for 2 marks, brake power for 2 marks, volumetric efficiency 2 marks, swept volume 2 marks, and the leftover diameter and length of cylinder is 2 marks. Hence, we are done with this problem. Hello guys, stay tuned for next part and make sure you like and subscribe, because in next part we are going to study multi-stage reciprocating compressors. If you have any doubt regarding single-stage reciprocating compressors, please do write in the comment box. Bye!